This video is a really quick tour around Microsoft To Do, which is the service that I use for my project management tool. Now, I have used this for over a decade, really, really consistently. And I think that that can be kind of a sign that I love it and that it works really well for me. Disclaimer is that what works for me will not necessarily work for you, but I know it can be helpful and interesting to see how people use their favorite tools. And so I'm going to show you some of the ways that I utilize this and how I have it set up. One thing I want to point out before we get started is that all of the services I use for my digital systems are available both on desktop as well as on apps. So I'm going to be showing you Microsoft To Do on my desktop computer today, but there's also an app that you can put on your phone and everything syncs between the two. So you can access it from pretty much everywhere, which is one of my favorite things about it. So like I said, I've used Microsoft To Do for well over a decade. It was previously called Wunderlist, which you may or may not recall. And then it was acquired by Microsoft and kind of rolled into their suite of products. It's free to use and they make it really accessible even if you don't use other Microsoft products. And so if you happen to notice that To Do is like the only Microsoft product that I use and a lot of my other systems are in Google, that is correct. I've just been really loyal to To Do ever since it was Wunderlist back in the day and have stuck with it. And the thing I love about To Do is that it can be super simple, but it can also be as complex as you need it to be. So looking at this interface right now, hopefully you're thinking like, wow, that looks really clean and organized and simplistic, but I'm gonna show you how you can kind of put it to work for you and make it as complex as you want it to be. So I'm gonna start by just kind of explaining the basic structure of To Do. So over here on the left side, you're gonna have folders, and I would use these for like kind of your bigger overarching things. So for me, that is business, clients, and personal. And that's kind of how my work is split up, right? I either have like projects for my own business, projects for my clients, or personal things. And so personal are things like our grocery list, things I need my husband to do around the house, movies we want to watch, books I want to read, TV shows, like all like what to pack for vacation. And I love that I can have these organized also right alongside my work. Clients are just my client list and things that I'm working on for them. And then under my business, I have basically by topic, all these different lists. And so going back here, you have these higher kind of overarching topics in folders. Within the folder, you're going to have lists and you can kind of split those up however you want. I kind of have them by topic or project. So you'll see that I have like my to-dos for my shop, but also my newsletter. But I also have things by project. So things I need to do for this December course, things I need to do for the last half effort, which was my free end of year coaching program. And then as you click on a list, you'll then have tasks. So these are the tasks that I need to complete on that list. And within each task, you then over here on the right have task details. So closing back out of that once again, I'm just going to show you again. So these big overarching folders, list divided by, you know, topic or project, whatever makes sense for you. And then within the list, you have tasks, and within each task, you have all of these task details over here. Now, two things that I want to point out are first that this can be collaborative. And so if you have a virtual assistant or team members, or you're working on a large team, you can add people to the different lists so that you can collaborate and move tasks around. I really only collaborate on personal lists. So for example, my husband and I are both on this shared grocery list that we can both add items to or cross items off of. I think that's really convenient since you can hop onto the app version, like when you're in the store and see your grocery list, and both of us can access it. So we can be in the grocery store at the same time and can see what the other person is going around and picking up and checking off. Over here in the task details, you can always add a note. So you can see I went down here and just added last row of freezer section. So maybe it's easier to find. I could also go in here and add a file if that would make it easier. So I can upload a photo here of what the edamame looks like. So that's just a quick example of a personal use for it, but let's go up and look at a work-related task. So for example, during the course that you're in, one of the tasks that I need to do every day is moderate course comments. And so I've gone in here and created a task for moderating course comments. I've set it to start on Monday, November 28th, the first day of class, and I've set it to repeat daily. So that means that as soon as I check this off on the 28th, it's going to pop up for the 29th. And once I cross it off on the 29th, it'll pop up for the 30th. So it'll keep it on my task list every day as a recurring task I need to perform. Another thing that I do when I'm adding work-related tasks is I set a category. So I'm going to X out of this. But you can see in the drop-down menu here, I have added my categories to be time-specific so that I can set durations for the tasks. And I'm going to show you why this comes in to be helpful in a minute. But basically, I can just create an estimate here of how long I think this task will take me. So I'll go ahead and set that for 20 minutes. Another tip that I have for to-do is that when you create your lists, I like to name them with an emoji at the beginning. So all you do is go up to edit the name of your list. And when you're in there, just copy and paste an emoji that makes sense for the type of list that it is. And I'm going to show you in a second why that's helpful. But that's the basic gist of setting up Microsoft To-Do. So you just want to set up folders for your bigger overarching themes. Within those, create lists that make sense for your work. And then start adding tasks to those. And those tasks, you might want to make them recurring if they're things that you do monthly, weekly, daily. You might want to set categories so that you can kind of tag or flag or categorize them in a way that makes sense to you. You can add files, you can add notes, and if you have team members, you can share the task with them. Now, my favorite thing about To-Do is that I can have all of these different lists with all these different tasks with various deadlines, file attachments, information attached to them. But it has this really cool feature built in called Planned. So once you click on Planned, what it's going to do is it's going to pull all the tasks from your list based on due date. So it's telling me that today, these are the two big projects that I need to be focused on and working on. It's telling me that tomorrow, these are the things from all of my lists that I should work on, and so on. So what needs to be worked on before Friday? What about next week? So I can kind of just scroll ahead and see what types of projects I have to be working on. Now, the two things I want to point out here are that it's nice to have those emojis in the list names, because just by kind of scanning through here, I can see that my work today and tomorrow is really focused on my December course, just by kind of seeing that emoji in there. And I can see that next week is going to be really heavy on administrative tasks, just by seeing that emoji in there. Now, because I've also done time estimates and used that to categorize them by color, I can also glance at this and see what is the commitment to the projects I really need to get done today. And you'll learn about this later in the course, but this is really handy when you're assessing your schedule and identifying your available blocks of time and then assigning appropriate tasks to those blocks, because I can look and say, okay, I have an open 30 minutes in the morning. What should I work on? Well, finalizing the course workbook is going to take an hour, and so I don't really want to try diving into that when I only have 30 minutes. But sending out this email to all registered attendees takes 20 minutes, so I can schedule that into that 30-minute time block instead. So again, that's just a really quick overview of Microsoft To-Do and what I really truly love about it. Like I said, I'm a longtime user, so any questions that you have about it, let me know. I'm happy to answer them. Also happy to do more tutorials on it or talk about it in the live Q&A if there's other stuff you want to know about it.